Thursdays, and welcome to episode 187 of Lave Radio, the show that likes to talk about the universe of the week and the fantastic beauty that surrounds it. I'm your host, Colin, Commander Phoenix Kavaya, or Head of Archives at PlayStation, and joining me in the on-site lineup for this episode, we have our chief, Lars Stewart, Rance Cypher-Galuba. We have our chief head of health and safety, Ben Bosswood. Otherwise, there is quite a
while
behind
you. While I'm trying to fly in, thank
you. Okay. Multitasking is not his thing. We have the legend. Director of Pest Control. Oh no, we haven't got the director of Pest Control. We've got our Inhuman Resources Director, Commander Sharon.
Okay.
No. And we have the Ninth Extruder Operator, Commander Kurgon.
Got that right?
Good evening. Otherwise, not Sandy. But we'll stick with Commander Kurgon. And do we have Sabrine?
Yeah, hello.
Hello. Sabrine is the editor. Are you the editor or a editor? Subject to yourself.
A.
The three of you, yes. So, we've been joined by Sabrine to discuss the latest issue which came out. Was it Monday?
It came out on Monday.
Excellent. So, obviously we'll be discussing that later on, but feel free to make any contributions as we go along. So, we'll just have a quick catch-up. We'll start with Commander Shan.
I'm doing very well, thank you. Earning pennies. And in-game, I have been busy gathering engineering materials again to go through another set of engineering ready for version 3.
So are you actually engineering like mad at the moment, or are you just stuck?
Bit of both. So I'm engineering stuff I know of you, like man, just doing a great client role on stuff on train shifts, thrusters, etc. I don't really care about myself. Just my part of the intermediate shift. So while I've got a nerve, engineered climate change, power plant, for example, I'll go back and set the map. Yeah. Back up again to that level.
Okay. What have you been up to this week?
I've mainly been doing some, community bowling and things like that. So I've been doing that. But I don't know if anyone can hear me on the Twitch stream yet or not. I hope they can. What else have you been doing? I've been playing Grimlord a fair bit as well, actually. That's approaching it, the end of its alpha. Or paper or whatever stage of that.
So, right, fair enough then. It is time for that favourite point of the week. What's the bathroom update? Right, now you mean. You do. You need something like a flush.
Oh, that would be terrible. Right, perhaps inside that is, could I say to be down went the first coating on the floor and the ceiling, the first water seal is down, then the second water seal down, then the ground is down, then the house is going to clean up with him.
For a second there, I thought that was the first flush. But, moving on.
Not quite. But yeah, that's, I mean, I can tell if you get a couple of days work and we've got a door frame that's been adjusted when we put on one of these push doors. Friction free and very easy swing driver which seems to do. So it's an exciting bit to see how to put that down. If you haven't got a clue, I should be able to
do it. I must admit, there are people on Twitch who are there, so really excited about the bathroom update. It's a little bit, well, stoppingly worrying.
Maybe we can go. There's a way for people that can come and use it.
That's not how I do it. Can I have a curly fuzz?
little turn bar off the floor that pointed like the red thing.
Ah dear. So, Commander Kirby. How's your week been? That's something I'm looking forward to actually, the Guardian update, of where we are with that. And finally, Sabine, what have you been up to for the last week?
Probably
obviously releasing a magazine.
I don't have any updates about any of my rooms, not today, especially not my bathroom, because it remains entirely static for the entire week. I'm really sorry. So what have I been doing? There's a new woman moved in a flat above mine, so I've been drinking a bottle of wine with her and hearing about her moving in time. So it's pretty dull, but similarly domestic.
Right.
So how have you gone up the central line bar of magic the line is?
I thought it was coffee.
I got a gold pen.
Yeah. And there we should.
Gold pen. Kids are using the phones.
Did he get to?
I don't know.
Well, it's certainly time left or right or whatever the hell it is to say stop on.
There's a few jokes here. Good plunge for plunge for exams. I think in 50 years. But never mind. Sorry, we did. We're on the Officer Tank branch of So, I've been helping out rebuild the Oracle, so at the moment I'm down with Pleiades, helping out the IEA, the OT9, shifting as much vulnerable stuff I can to try and get at least one station back online before I just hit the bubble. On top of that, I've finally managed to get all the engineers unlocked and upgraded by the park from Bill Turner. And I must admit, when I saw what his requirements were, I just went, God, I'm not really looking forward to it.
It's
very rare material.
You don't actually need to unlock the
some of them you can hit level 3 to unlock the level 5 one.
Yeah, well, I just wanted, my OCD's kicking in, I want to catch them all. You know what I mean?
I'm the same, I've actually maxed out all the engineers I can get to grade 5, even though some of them I have, there's no point using them after grade 3.
Yeah, Marco Quint, stupid bit. Oh, he's my hated engineer. I don't care what anybody else says, he was my absolute hated engineer.
I think he's every... I'm pretty sure Marco Quent is like the galaxy's most hated member.
Oh, I don't know, I think he's engineer with 200 tons of whatever rare good it was. Was it changed to 50?
That was pretty funny.
Yeah, I mean, we'll be touching on engineers and probably stuff like that later, but... and other news, I have rediscovered the joys of retro gaming. To borrow a phrase from Mammy Witherspoon, I've been retro gaming so you don't have to. I did the old gold box of Full of Radiance, which basically is a 1988 RPG. My god, we must have had such boring little lies to find that more exciting. Well, that's moving on. We have had a little bit of a surprise this afternoon. Have a drink.
Just a wee bit.
Just a wee bit. Now, we weren't, I personally weren't expecting this, but we have announced the 2.0 release date. for those of you who have had your head stuck in the sand or haven't had an email from Frontier yet, it was the 27th of February, getting beyond Chapter 1, 3.0 as it's otherwise known. So, we have a trailer. So Ben, would you like to play the trailer? And for those of you listening on the podcast, we'll skip the trailer and just discuss it after.
I will happily do that once I get my microphone turned on, but you're gonna have to wait a second when the deep size my monitor. Because this could be interesting. How do I do this?
I don't know the exact.
Oh, I'm not speaking at that, I'm not on my for a res. How can I just make it to real life?
says a man, never.
I need to know how to make it smaller!
Can I join in? Hi guys.
Oh, hi.
I'm being late.
Doctor, how are you?
Bending off with some serious hiccups right now. I've had them for 3 days. I'm currently sat drinking not sick and eating crisps just so I can talk to you guys.
Bye.
So what have you been up to for the last, well, apart from being ill, have you been up to anything in the game, Dr. Toxic?
No, I haven't been in the game, unfortunately, but I have been making preparations to start a bit of development work in Risk OS. Operating system derived from Acorn, from BBC Micro, which is the original platform for the Elite game in 1984. So they've been bringing Risk OS back using the Raspberry Pi, which is the chief development PC that everybody knows about.
According to, you can still run Arc Elite on the Raspberry Pi, is that right?
I haven't tried it, but I do have a Raspberry Pi running Risk OS sitting in front of me right now, so I'll try that.
Yeah, because that's the one version of the I've never played, and I've always been told it's the best version of classic games.
If I can get it to run on the Raspberry Pi, I'll bring it to Lavecon so you can all sit down and have a play.
We are ready for the video yet? Oh, Dave, you've got the video
ready. Are we ready,
yet?
Dave?
Oh, Dave.
I'm going to do this change the noise of water.
But you're supposed to be a technical genius, Ben.
I'm not playing with my monitor in these resolutions. I'm not used to being so big.
Again, something that no man has ever said ever.
I've got up a couple of monitors to test it will be 1080p again. Hopefully that can work. Okay, I think we're good. This could all be ended for self-defense.
Absolutely.
Excellent.
Yeah, will it?
Probably not. Right, let's try this then.
It's quite a short trailer, really, isn't it? But I do believe everybody's got a little bit to talk about here. I mean, obviously the first thing is the GTP. So we saw the GTP, we've seen the flight component. Anybody just want to jump in?
But it seemed to happen. I might quickly let paint the top of it. And
I
want to start with quite customers are wanting us to do that. So it seems to be an extra.
Well, yeah, especially if you're close to a producer, that's quite scary. What else? What else was in the trailer that they got to go in there?
What?
In order.
I'm not sure if what was it? What are these again?
That's audio stuff?
Yeah, I'm counting audio, but also what my eyes are headlining is the headline on top of escalating cyborg threats. So it may be consistent. So if you are currently in LT700, I will check out Pro 2, because according to the trailer, there should be a massive cyborg threat in it. Possibly by the web now. The S-Lite system, moderate amount, on the south-southwest, and in black hours. So I would suggest if you're an LT700 or S-Lite, it's in black hours.
Unless of course you've got the extra against their perimeter. I mean, on the subject of the weapons, that gun looks very Guardian.
It's deep, isn't it?
It basically looks like a monolith that they stuck on the ship.
They seem to show it being fired as well, but I didn't recognise the jet arm in the scene after it. So whether it's some kind of power gun or a plasma, I'm not sure, but
it's got a name of a plasma charger, it looks like in the video.
There's a Gauss, I think it says Gauss cannon on the secondary fire on that screen as well.
Wow. I mean, I missed all that stuff. I mean, I haven't got through it in my brain. I mean, I did like the Thargoid and Scouts being chased by the window. That reminded me. That actually reminded me of the Frontier intro for some reason.
I guess so, yeah. I hadn't thought about that. Yeah.
Of course, there was Megaship Piracy, which... did that look like a brand new Megaship? The Rocky Gold Green Dome.
It did look good. It looked like a new one, but they made it look like it was in motion because the chief was flying towards it, but I don't think it was.
That could be an evacuation.
You think in Battlestar Galactica where everybody's got their own little gardens?
Well, not so much in their little gardens, but it looks like an awful lot of gardening rooms and sort of definitely oxygen production and food production. So it could be a megaship that is getting people to head out of Dodge.
I'm just thinking Silent Running or something.
Yeah, every time I look at it, I'm like, Huey and Dewey in that.
Yeah. I mean, we did see some piracy going on with that megaship, which I thought was quite interesting. I don't know whether or not, well, if anyone played it repeatedly, do you think that they chucked out their cargo for your trouble?
No, not. They have spent a lot of money, and make it more valuable as well, probably, the correct way.
Yeah. And finally, an SRV approaching some sort of new structure, which seemed to glow with a kind of guardian type of light.
Yes, that's pretty cool, although I have speculated that the pyramid thing in the background could be a frame. I'm not sure I think.
Oh yeah, interesting. I see where they're getting at. But if you look on the right hand or left hand side of the picture, it looks like you've got a similar structure there as well, so yeah, when you've got the Guardian into action in the fog, the cargoes around there destroyed the Federal Battlecruiser, so it's good to see that's going to keep on coming on, because I do like the did enjoy the taking the cargo scouts and whatever ship.
One thing I did notice where Frontier is a bit clever in that scene with the SRV and the Guardian is they seem to black out on the car and they can't locate the car. Unless I can't see the resolution of the show now, I couldn't see a star.
Oh, I hope they don't.
But they're great at most of it. Looking at it now, it's two or three. But yeah, you couldn't find out where it was.
You say that we surprised that Hammond did go and follow it through and say, yeah, it's just trying to come on around the corner.
But did you just put a fake star cruiser and deliberately send it to the wrong places?
Oh, I mean, I would love that. Everyone's doing it. But I'm sure it's around Proxima Centauri, but we can't. There's nothing there. There's just this wee anecdote that we're having to get. Did you see the suggestion that a tourist beacon could run into an orbital to explain about the planet?
No.
Yeah, someone put the suggestion that a tourist beacon should be there to go, ha 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 ha.
We should put an engineer there.
An engineer? I'm picked up an orbital. Yeah, what's he going to make? The mug cannon.
Many skipping bit dubs allow you to get from, point 2 light years quicker.
Yes, this is Stargate. He's building a Stargate.
Skip drive, that's what it's going to make. Jumps.
Right. No, maybe that's what we want. That is exactly where the jump gate to Colonial is set. Maybe we should start a new one. If you want to get to Colonia fast, head to an orbital. So, I mean, newsletter 214. I think most of it has been kind of superseded by the news today.
I think a lot of people want to have to actually get to the top. I don't think anyone else can take it.
Well, no. I must admit, I did get it. It did turn out a bit late for me, but we're looking at striking vultures. Project 186 that came to conclusion this week. I guess we'll touch on that later as well. Operation IDA, which is the group that I've been helping out with the article. And the usual chats about community goals. Did anyone see the thing about the synth wave to space? I must admit, I missed that one, so I'm going to have to double check that one.
We've approached the artist and we wanted to do the front cover of the next magazine.
Oh, that'd be nice.
Yeah, so good.
And what's this about the world famous chocolate bars? Someone been delivering chocolate bars to Frontier Towers. They don't want my pizzas.
To be honest, I think we need to kill them with pizzas. When you start crashing space stations out of pizza boxes, you've taken it too far.
That was it. You have to go far back for a second.
Well,
that's
something
I do. We've had,
am I right? It was a large problem that had tons of pizzas. We bought it when I was on the Tuesday. Or three, wasn't it?
We raised £500 and it was two for Tuesday and I got a 50% off site voucher. I had to do two batches to keep it under the maximum that you could pay online. And yeah, and with the discount card that was twice as much of an order. I phoned them and made sure they were aware of it, which is why we know if all our pizza boxes because they had hundreds of other.
Yeah,
I think all in it was about £800 to £900 worth.
So what did the speaker restaurant say when it came in? Because wouldn't they
says, you're like, you're having a laugh, mate. You're not going to get our money. You're going to deliver it to a caravan.
Well, no, to be honest, they seem to be able to handle it without any problems. You know, they didn't even bat an eyelid at all. The only problem was when they phoned me for directions. I don't live in England. I've never been to it. I don't even know what you're talking about. So they phoned the wrong number, gave them my number, and yeah. So there was never an issue. We gave them plenty of notice. And leave for people to find out what time would be most suitable for them. And all because, you know, they would say that things would be released around dinner time, so we'd try and get them dinner as quickly as possible.
Yeah, well, it's still a classic Michael Brooks piece of gold rule. We'll release it when someone buys us pizza, and how pizza Julia Rocky.
It was good. I mean, obviously, what happened is if anyone, wasn't around at the time, they kindly kind of asked us, and for the launch party, when we were down at the Expo Lunch, we created a plaque. We collected money that we would normally have collected for pizza, and we put it in two checks for, it was Special Effects, and what's the other charity that David Green's a huge fan of?
Oh, I can't remember. I know it wasn't Hearing Trust, because that's what you guys do.
Yeah, that's the Hutton. It was another gaming charity, if I remember right, and can't remember it. So we split it between the two of us and presented them the plaque and checks in a pizza box on the stage, and then we kind of sent in a greed that the Frontier Tutor staff, well, that we don't need the community to send us pizzas, as much as they really, really appreciated the kindness, and they would rather that we put that funding such to charities where they could use the funds for more than just developing high levels of cholesterol and heart disease.
Yeah, I was wondering whether or not we'd actually, I did notice they put out a call for the new developers not long afterwards. I did wonder whether or not our pieces killed quite a lot.
I did think I'd fight the background on a lot of weight in the early years. She was like one who bring up the main decision to the left. Taking 3 years to leave it again.
Yeah, pizza boy. Oh, dear, no.
Yeah, but the hallucinations from all that pizza that led into making that snake.
I'm just thinking about the consultation. That's probably just what my mind goes into.
Oh, yeah.
You're thinking that's a poop sock. There's no such thing as a poop sock.
No, you're just thinking of how we fucking go.
I won't,
but
thank you for
mentioning. No, let's not. I don't
think
that people want to really know about the people's bowel habits. But on the subject of Sancho, he's been on the forums quite a lot recently discussing the new credit punishment. Well, Ed summarised the new credit punishment stuff, of course, on the forums. And Sancho's been heavily involved in discussions about the kill wards. Now, it's been going on that long, I've never really lost where we are with the kill wards. So, Sham, and anybody else who's following who hasn't got lost, would you kindly kick in and explain to me what the situation is?
The situation is, as far as we know, that we meet the three kill wards, and is the one that is going to be in. On release. However, Sancho has said the change they're looking at could possibly take it in to release. So they've got about a week for any changes if they still want to have that. So the jury is still out. It's coming today. My gut feel says it could be the PS3 version because they're running out of time to get through some points.
Yeah, I mean that's always an issue. You want to keep everything in sync now, isn't it?
It is. I mean, it's potentially quite problematic for the bounty hunters in being carried in as the freak released. So I'm hoping if it does go in, then they'll fix it or change it. there's a great impact, quite a lot of about capturing the part of the game.
Can you actually explain why it breaks? Because I haven't understood it. All that I seem to have got from all this is that people have complained because they don't get as much money as they used to.
Well, the issue has never been about the money. It's about how down to the mechanic to boost reputation within a system or the PG. So currently, in PG 3, the highest count point you've got is still 1%. Which is great if the highest count was the one that belongs to PG giver. But if it wasn't, then you can't really nothing for the CG for that.
Right, okay.
And also, if you then use the kill warrant scanner, you run the risk of overwriting a bounty you wanted to the bounty you didn't. So you're better off not carrying your kill warrant scanner at all, and just unshift the scanning normally.
I'm a little bit confused about that one. It overwrites a bounty that you don't get.
The way it works is that you can only ever hack in one bounty.
Oh, right, I see. So basically what you're saying is if you're in a CG and you see someone who's obviously a target of a faction, you go after them, you shoot them down as normal without using the kill warrant scanner, you get the bounty drop to middle. That comes from the CG.
Yeah. And you get a higher attack somewhere else.
A different faction at that point, that makes the question. Right, now.
It's a little bit more subtle than that. So, say for example, the first bit coming from belongs to action 3. But the highest attack is the next. So, the ship has two bounces on it. So, in the character, you get back to the also, actually like to do more if you want to win someone they want to get. And in the new system, you get faction only. So now faction 3 doesn't want to get 50 blue on its members.
Okay, but I'm not following that. I thought the faction C would be bothered either way. Because I thought you were saying that faction C were after this guy anyway.
Yes, it doesn't know. Don't take that. It's a kill. And as far as faction C knows, you killed one of his mates.
So would it have been more useful that when you actually basically shoot a ship down, you give it an option of all the bounties it's got in that ship and you can choose one?
That's what happens now.
Well, that's what happens now, so when you shoot
it, you get a list.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah, but it's not. Yeah, I mean, normally they're quite good at getting this turned around quite quick if it's urgent. I mean, the way that the person is to respond to this in the world, it seems it wants people to stay.
I hope the whole Hill Warren presentation system is very promising. I mean, if we use it for all sorts of different ways of playing the game. So, yeah, something that you can do with CG, for example, and the CG only system isn't that great to count. What they'll do is they'll move to a system close by and test the count, even though the system owner doesn't belong to the faction that runs the CG system. So they'll move a move system to advance the CG system. But the way they're talking about it currently, you won't be able to do that. Adding to it. So there's all sorts of variations and subsidies. That actually makes it really complicated. There's so many people using it very different ways.
I must admit, the new Chrome Chronicle thing, the stuff that's come out so far, that Ed thankfully summarised. And I hope they can summarise and do a similar summary like this for engineering as well. But it did clear up a few things I was still having trouble with, because I don't know whether or not it wasn't explained originally well enough, or I just got the wrong impression, but thankfully the stuff that Ed summarised before did help to clear a few cobwebs away. So, moving on from there, though, the commander...
Hello.
I am pronouncing that correctly.
Yes, Duverine.
Duverine, well, Liam pronunciations. Number one for good mispronunciations. Congratulations on issue 6 coming out. Now, we've all had a look at this. Now, if anybody hasn't heard of this subject on your side, would you like to give us a brief summary of what it is?
Sagittarius Eye is a monthly online magazine for Elite Gaming. It's completely in character in the universe, it's totally made by commanders, for commanders, our sort of mission, as it were, is to tell the story of players actually in game, what they get up to. So it's less game. Less scout net, less, what isn't about it or whatever. It's more, telling stories of what ordinary players are out there doing.
Okay, now I do believe, Cal, we've got an advert for this.
Yes,
you can put a piece of paper to the case.
Not a problem at all, seeing as you asked some things. Give me 2 seconds and then you grab one. Sorry?
I'm gonna put another advert on first, and that'll let me pop the audio streams over from what you guys are saying on the computer on the live stream.
Yeah, no problem. Here we go.
Okay. I'm going to shut you guys off the system. Bye.
Mics are clear. That's just Ben bouncing
about. When you get here, we'll point out all the little bits and scratches that make the colours get smaller and smaller before we actually give you any more. So the beauty is, you take any ship,
we should now only be doing that if I had about 10 seconds.